Hello chess friends and welcome to the channel. In today's video we go back to the 19th century because we have for too long forgot the great Paul Morphy. The year is 1852, the city is New Orleans and the game is Mc Connell versus Paul Morphy. At the time Paul Morphy is 15 years old and he plays another interesting game against James Mc Connell, a Louisiana lawyer and member of the New Orleans Chess Club. Let's start with the game. James Mc Connell with the white pieces opens with e4 and Paul Morphy answers with e5. Knight to f3, knight to c6, and here comes bishop to c4. Bishop to c5 and b4, Mc Connell plays the Evans Gambit. The best way to fight this gambit is to accept it. Paul Morphy captures with the bishop on b4. Here comes c3, threatening the bishop and supporting a future d4 push, and Paul Morphy retreats the bishop to a5. Here comes the first big inaccuracy. Instead of d4 directly, that is much better, Mc Connell plays short castle. But castling slow things much down. Knight to f6, d4 now, castle for black. And also, knight capture on e4 is a good move, probably even a tiny better, but Morphy doesn't want to open the center with the king still on the e-file. So, short castle, d capture on e5, knight capture on e4, two pieces are attacking c3, here comes bishop to a3, threatening the rook, and here comes d6, a good move. Let's go back one move, of course. Rook to e8 is a great mistake because there is the classical motif. Queen to d5, this battery attacking f7 and also attacking the unprotected knight. So let's go back to the game, d6, good move, and here comes another inaccuracy. E capture on d6, but after knight capture back on d6, this knight recapture gains one tempo. And the bishop must go back to b3. Let's go back some moves. Instead of e capture, the best idea is bishop to d5, threatening the knight. The knight doesn't have many squares where to go. The best answer seems to capture on c3. Here comes knight capture on c3, and white solved one development problem. Bishop capture on c3, and here with a simple calculation, instead of moving the rook to c1, there is e capture on d6, bishop capture on a1, d capture on c7, threatening the queen, also opens a discovery attack against the rook. Queen capture on c7, bishop capture on f8, black remains a pawns up, is a bit better, but is a bit behind in development, and white has drawing chances. Let's go back to our game. Instead of bishop to d5, he captures, knight recapture, threatening the bishop must go back to b3, and here comes another developing move, bishop to g4, pinning the knight. h3, bishop to h5, and queen to d5, attacking the bishop. Bishop to g6, and here comes knight to e5. Two pieces attacking c6, and Paul Morphy, he changed the knight. Knight capture on e5, and here comes an important decision to take. Where to recapture? The bishop or the knight? Mc Connell makes a strategic decision and he captures on a5, winning the bishop pair. But there is a problem, and it is a big one. The queen, like almost all the other white pieces, are on the queen side, and with queen to g5, Paul Morphy can start a direct attack on the castle. After king to h1 and bishop to e4, threatening checkmate in one and pinning the pawn, you see how strong this attacking formation really is. Let's go back some moves. Queen capture on a5 was a mistake. The right recapture is queen capture on e5. Here comes b5, gaining space on the queen side and shielding the bishop that was still under attack. Probably the best idea for white is to try to exchange queens with bishop capture on d6, queen recapture, queen capture on d6, because if white tries to gain back the pawn with queen capture on b5, here comes bishop to d3, the queen now is forced to capture the bishop, queen capture, bishop captures, and king capture to f1, but now queen to h2 is a really strong move. Bishop to d5 is at least an idea to keep protecting g2, but after queen to h1 we check, and king to e2, rook in a goes to d8, not only the rook is not attacked anymore, but the bishop is sort of pinned, because if the bishop move away, then queen to d1, supported by the rook, and with the other rook ready to move to e8, is a simple win in few moves. So this bishop is sort of pinned and will be captured with c6. So let's go back. The best idea is to exchange the queen. C recapture on d6. a4 now, b4, c capture, bishop capture, and after knight to a3, even if for the computer this was the best idea, with the bishop pair and the pawn up, it's likely that Paul Morphy could win easily this endgame. Maybe not easily, but could win the endgame. Let's go back a bit. We said capturing the knight is the right recapture. After b5, instead of exchanging queen, another practical possibility is to play queen to f4, with the idea that with the queens still on the board, the white can try to create some more problems to his opponent, but unfortunately there are not many attacking possibilities because the position is really complicated. Here comes rook to c8 that will support c5, bishop to b4 trying to force black to exchange the bishop and improve the pawn structure, but black of course will decline this offer. Here comes knight to d2, c5 attacking the bishop, bishop to a3, bishop to c7 indirectly attacking the queen. The best idea is to play queen to f3, but here comes c4, bishop to d1 with the bishop that disconnect the rooks. It's -3 because white position completely lacks any coordination. So let's go back to our game. We said McConnell captured the bishop because he wanted the bishop pair, but he didn't notice that in few moves black attack is really strong. Paul Morphy plays queen to g5, king to h1 breaking the pin, but here comes bishop to e4 threatening checkmate in one. I want to show you one thing. After queen to g5, it's true that the queen is leaving the protection of this pawn, but if queen capture on c7, this attack becomes impossible to stop. Bishop to e4, g3, knight to f3 we check, king to h1, queen to h5 with the idea of giving checkmate, h4, but here comes knight capture on h4 with the discovery check. The king must move, again an eye check that opens the way for the queen to give checkmate. So king to h1 breaking the pin is not a bad move. Bishop to e4, beautiful move and simple to play because a second piece is attacking one of the squares around the king. Here comes f3, bishop sacrifice, bishop capture, g capture, and queen to g3 with the idea of queen capture on h3. McConnell plays knight to d2, that is perfectly understandable because he connect the rooks and at least the piece is now developed and trying to protect f3. And just a bit better was bishop capture on d6 that removes one of the attacking pieces. Here comes at first queen capture on h3, king to g1, c recapture the bishop, knight to d2, and here something that we are quite familiar with, queen to g3 we check, king to h1, queen to h4 we check, and you know who the target is. I'm sure you know. King to g2, queen to g5, forking the knight, the unprotected piece. King to h1 and queen capture d2. f4, attacking the knight. Here comes a beautiful idea. Rook in a goes to e8. The pawn can't capture because this move will lose on the spot. There is the rook recapture, attacking the queen and completely shutting out the queen from any type of defense. Then the rook will move to the h-file and it's an impossible to avoid checkmate. In this position, a clever idea is bishop capture on f7 we check. Of course, black can't capture or it's checkmate in 3. But the simple king to h8 is enough because white is still facing the same mate pattern. So, knight to d2, this is the game again. Knight to f5, another piece is coming to the attack. Rook in a goes to e1, queen capture on h3 we check, and king to g1. Rook in f goes to e8. This piece is attacking twice, but white can't capture, because if rook capture, queen to g3, we check, is also a fork, king to h1, and rook capture, also gaining one tempo, and this is a mess. So after king to g1, rook in f goes to e8, rook to f2, trying at least to protect the second rank, but here comes queen to g3, we check, also pinning the rook. King to f1 and the beautiful knight to d3 supporting two different checkmate. Queen capture on f2 and rook capture on e1. James Mc Connell tries rook capture on e8 we check, but rook recapture and again the same two mate threats. Here bishop capture on f7, king to h8, and here McConnell resigns because it's a forced checkmate in 3. Let's watch together. Knight to e4 that blocks the way for the rook and also protect f2 seems to hold everything, but a simple removal of the guard, rook capture on e4, and this pawn can't capture because it checkmate here. So rook to e2, and here another simple but beautiful tactic, knight to e3 we check, and this is a win in deflection because the king can't move and the rook is forced to capture, leaving the protection of the second rank. Here comes queen to f2 and he checkmate. So another beautiful attacking game by Paul Morphy, and I hope that you enjoyed it. Many big tournaments are going to start. Today night, that is afternoon in the United States, the Champion Showdown in St. Louis. Also, the Aeroflot Elite Tournament 2019 was going to start yesterday, but unfortunately, round one was suspended because of a fake bomb alarm in the hotel. And luckily, no one was injured, nothing happened. And today, round one will be played again. So don't forget to subscribe to the channel because many great games are coming. For now, thanks for watching and goodbye.